Hey, just down below the video, if you click like, that'll make sure that YouTube shows this video to more people. Thanks. Oh, this is wild. Brand new in beta, a new way to have expanding dynamic sized ranges, a new way to reference ranges with an extra dot or two extra dots. Check it out. Hey, we got something really new and exciting today, a new, better way to refer to ranges that are going to expand or contract. You know, in the past, we might have done something crazy where you just refer to the entire column because you don't know how many rows there are going to be. And that's inefficient because Excel has to look at all of those rows. So we have this new thing called TRIMRANGE. Let's take a look at the function argument there. TRIMRANGE. So we specify a range and then the row trim mode. So the choices there are to get rid of any trailing blanks, empty cells at the bottom. Leading is the empty cells at the top. 3 is the default to get rid of both at the top and the bottom. You can see right here this example. If we ask for the trim range of B colon B, and I don't have to specify the comma 3 because I'll take either the top or the bottom, then that is going to analyze a smaller data set. All right, but here's the amazing thing, right? They have a new formula, a range notation. Check this out. If we say B colon and then a period or a full stop or a dot, I'm just going to call it a dot. This B colon dot B says get rid of all of the values at the end, the trailing, right? If we would change the dot to put the dot before the colon, then it would get rid of the leading blanks. If you put a dot both before and after the colon, then it's going to get rid of leading and trailing. Now here, this is an amazing thing. We said, well, what about data validation? Data validation. In the data validation source, allow anything from A2 colon dot down to A30. So that means as this range grows, the data validation is going to grow. So right here, we can choose, and it goes down to guava. I'll add something else down here, jicama. And when I go back, that range should have automatically grown, right? So hey, it's working with data validation. Now I tried it with charts. I can't get it to work with charts. With pivot tables, it's only half working. It kind of like takes a look at that range and locks it into the pivot table as hard-coded. All right, now, so here's one where we're going to add more columns or rows. We don't know. So you can see that the B2 colon dot down to E10. But instead of just taking an average here, which returns one number, I said, let's just divide everything by 2. So that gives us a spilled range, and it shows us what's being returned. So we want everything from B2 to E10, but you see that all of these empty cells here and empty cells here are not being returned. Like it's actually shrinking it down, which is perfect. But if I would add a number here, 1, 2, 3, 4, you see that then it extends the entire range. And if I would add a number here, let's just add 1, 2, 3s, control enter, then they get added in, right? Pretty cool how this is working. Now, with the whole thing with the trailing and the leading, these values down here are have the dots in various spots. So B2 to B15 divided by 2. And you see that because I'm asking for it to trim the trailing empty cells, everything after 385 is not being returned, but these two blanks at the top are being returned to zeros. If I would switch that formula to put the dot before the colon, then that's going to get rid of the two leading blanks like that, and we'll have all the trailing empty cells. And then the one that you know, you might want to use if you want to get rid of both leading and trailing blanks would be the dot colon dot. So it's there. So even if we have the colon dot colon, that's going to get rid of the leading blanks and the trailing blanks, but any blanks in the middle will continue to be returned. And of course, if you don't like this dot construct, the colon dot, you can do this all of this with trim range. So here the 2 is getting rid of trailing, here the 1 is getting rid of leading, and then here the 3, 3, 3 is getting rid of both leading and trailing. So whether you want to use trim range or just the shorter colon period notation, there's lots of different ways to go. There's been a lot of discussion about the period. Some people say that they want something bigger than the period. You know, some people thought of maybe a tilde, but there's some countries where the tilde is not on the keyboard. Someone in Germany wanted to use the two dots above the U. I don't know what that's called, that accent key, but I don't have that on my keyboard. So at least with the dot, everyone has it. I realize it's hard to see. You know, you have to be kind of careful when you're looking for that. But what a cool new thing. So you just have to hope for the flighting to get expanded so you can give this a try. Thanks to my friend Suat in Turkey who managed to get it on his laptop.
And thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. Hey, just below the video, click the store icon. We have a whole bunch of new mugs and shirts, professionally designed, all kinds of great, fun slogans for you or your favorite Exceler.
If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below.